Hey guys, welcome back. So in this video, I'm going to tell you three things that I wish I knew when I bought the Samsung Galaxy S8. Perfect. Hey guys, welcome back to Tech Trishant. If you are new here, thanks for stopping by. My name is Trishant. I'm an amateur photographer who loves technology like smartphones and laptops. I love reviewing them and comparing them so that you get to make a purchase decision and I can do all that while expressing my love for technology. If you would like to receive more videos from me in the future, then consider subscribing this channel, hitting the bell icon so that you never miss an update, and following me on Instagram and Twitter. Also tell me in the comment section some things that you wish you knew when you purchased the Samsung Galaxy S8. Also, if you like this video, then give this video a big like so the beautiful design of the Samsung Galaxy S8 along with great specs on paper makes you want to purchase it right away. But still, there are things that you should consider before buying the Samsung Galaxy S8 Plus, and the first and the main reason is the speaker quality. The sound quality of this phone is something which Samsung didn't concentrate on at all while launching this guy right here, because this phone has got really crappy speakers, pretty much distorted at high volumes, and they really don't sound great even at low volumes. So in my use case of this phone, I have always preferred to use some kind of headphones either wired or Bluetooth with this one, because the sound quality on this one is really bad and it really hurts your ears. So if sound quality is not a priority for you when you are planning to buy a smartphone, then you can definitely go with it. You have some great reasons to buy the Galaxy S8 Plus. I'll link the video up here so that you can check that out on why you should buy the Samsung Galaxy S8 in 2019. But in this case, for the sound quality, I wouldn't at all recommend this phone in any ear. Just test it out before you go out to purchase this phone. I didn't test it out much. So the second thing I wish I knew when I purchased the Samsung Galaxy S8 is the durability of the phone. The phone is really not that durable. The phone is definitely prone to cracks even after a single drop, so you really want to use a case. And if you use a case, the whole, you know, one of the selling point of the phone, that is the beautiful looks, that beautiful look gets hidden. So that's a kind of a trade-off you might want to make if you want to purchase the Samsung Galaxy S8. Although the bezels and the glass back look really amazing, they look really beautiful. It's one of the most beautiful phones in the market right now, but it can crack. The glass back can crack even after a single drop on a cemented floor, and that's not a really good thing. So this phone is not that durable, and you always might want to use a case with it whenever you're taking this phone out for walks or hikes or something like that, because this phone would get cracked. I'm not telling you to not buy this phone, I'm just telling you that if you drop your phone a lot, buy a case for it and you will be better off. So the third thing that I wish I knew when I purchased the Samsung Galaxy S8 is the display burn-in issue, which I hope earlier that Samsung might have fixed from the S7 Edge. I had two S7 Edge and they both suffered with the issue of screen burn-in on the display. Over time, if it's an OLED screen and if you use your phone a lot, then some burn-ins can arrive in some kind of marks and it really shows up on the screen and doesn't look good. And over time, this issue worsens. This just has happened with the Galaxy S8. I don't know about the Galaxy S9 Plus. No burn-in is there till now on the Galaxy S9 Plus, and I hope there is no burn-in on that in the future also. But for the Galaxy S8, the screen burn-in issue is there and it has not yet been solved by Samsung. This is a thing which I really don't like on a smartphone, and this is one of the reasons why I prefer LCD screens over OLED, and why I've been using my iPhone 8 Plus till now, even after the iPhone 10, the 10s with the OLED displays have come out. If you are planning to use your phone for a long time, you might not want to consider at least the Samsung Galaxy S8 and its predecessors because of the screen burn-in issue. So these were the main things that I wish I knew when I purchased a Samsung Galaxy S8. Other than that, it's a really great phone. These are the things that you might want to consider before purchasing the Samsung Galaxy S8. The main things were sound quality. I wouldn't recommend at all for the sound quality. Durability, that problem can be solved with a case. And third thing is the OLED burn-ins. That is bound to happen if you purchase a Samsung Galaxy phone. So I hope you enjoyed this video and this video helped you. If it did, then give this video a big like, share this video with your friends and family, and follow me on Twitter and Instagram for more future and latest updates. Consider subscribing my channel and hitting that bell icon so that you never miss an update. Till the next time, have fun, keep loving technology, keep coming back to Tech Trishant. This is Trishant signing off. Peace.